Good morning, students. In the last class, we have completed the lesson Swami is expelled from school. And we have completed the story, grammar, vocabulary, writing, and study skills of that lesson. And today, we are moving to the other lesson. And the name of the lesson is Not Just a Teacher, But a Friend. It is a poem. If you see in your textbook, not just a teacher but a friend. I had nowhere to turn, had nowhere to go. This is just something I think you need to know. I don't know what made me trust you. I still remember the day when I told you what I have been through. I thought I should run away, go hide in a hole. But then you really brought my true soul. As each day grew longer, our trust became stronger. Each time I wanted to cry, you stayed there right by my side. Then I moved to the next grade. Boy, was I afraid that our trust would slowly fade. But I was wrong. We are still strong. Even though sometimes you don't have time, you at least ask me if I am fine. Even though sometimes I'm not, I feel like I have just been shot. I smile and say, yes, I'm all right. Then I walk away and you're out of sight. I'll just have to wait. I still have my fate. I'm so glad that you were there when I was sad. And this is what makes you not just my ninth grade teacher, my friend. So this poem, the speaker is a student. The student is expressing his views towards his teacher. So what he is telling is, I had nowhere to turn, had nowhere to go. He's telling that he is not having, means I had nowhere to turn, means he don't have any way to turn nor to go. There is just something I think you need to know. He's telling that it is just something which he think to know. I don't know what made me trust you. He's telling that what made me, I don't know what has made me to trust you. Trust means believe. The student is telling that I don't know that what made me to believe you. I still remember the day when I told you what I have been through. He's telling that I still remember that particular day, that when I told you what I have been through, means what is running in his mind, he has explained to his teacher. So he's telling that I still remember that particular day. I thought I should run away, go hide in a hole. So that student is telling that he has thought to run away or to go and hide in a hole. But then you really brought out my true soul. In that situation, his teacher has brought him out his true soul. Means what he is telling is, when he is in trouble, his teacher has understood his problem and asked and helped him to get out of it. And he has explained his true spirit, means what he can achieve. His teacher has explained him, and he has made him to stand in that position. As each day grew longer, our trust became stronger. So as days passed by, trust on his teacher also became strong. Each day I wanted to cry, you stayed there right by my side. So whenever he feel like to cry, his teacher was beside him making him strong. Then I moved to the next grade. Boy, was I afraid that was our trust would slowly fade. So what happened? He has moved to the next grade. Means he has completed his so-called class and he was moving to the next grade. Means next class. And he was afraid that his trust would slowly fade. Means fade means something becoming paler or less bright. So he was thinking that, the boy was thinking that as he was going to the another class, his belief means his relation with his teacher would slowly fade. But it was wrong. He was still strong. He is telling that I thought when I am changing my class that our strong relation would become slowly weak, means faded. But it was wrong, but still we are strong. Even though sometimes you don't have time, you at least ask me if I am fine. So even though the teacher don't have time also, he used to ask that whether he is fine or not. Even though sometimes I am not, I feel like I have just been shot. So what this boy is telling is, when his though his teacher is busy, he'll make time for him and he asks whether he's fine or not. At the time when he is in trouble also, he just give a smile and say, I'm all right. Then I walk away and you're out of sight. So he will say, though he is in trouble, he just smile and say, I'm all right. And his teacher will be moving, means his teacher will walk away from his sight. I'll just have to wait. I still have my fate. So what he's telling is, I have to wait till the fate, means still have my fate, thinking that everything will be all right. He has to wait. I'm so glad that you were there when I was sad. So what the student is telling is, I'm so glad that you are with me when I am sad. And this is what makes you not just my ninth grade teacher, my friend. So he's telling that this is what makes you not just a ninth grade teacher for me, but also a friend. The student is explaining his views about his teacher in this way. So if you see the whole summary of this poem, teachers change lives. Being the right person at the right time may be enough to change a person's life forever. Human beings are constantly changing, whether for the good or for the bad. We do not stay the same. Having a positive influence in the form of a teacher can make or break a human being. Years after we are out of school, we remember the teachers that changed our lives. In more cases, these may have been the first people that believed in us. That experience of having an authority figure believed that we could succeed carries us forever. The poem, Not Just a Teacher But a Friend, is a poem that describes the great role of a teacher in a student's life. The speaker of this poem is a student. The student says that he trusts his teacher and always remembers him when he was in trouble. That his teachers bring out the real soul in him and comforts him. By the passage of time, the trust between the teacher and him grew stronger. Every time he was in a trouble, the teacher stays with him and helped him. The students thought that his trust in his teacher would slowly disappear, but it became stronger and stronger as it was the real trust. Though the teacher is busy, he asked his student how he is. Though the student is in troubles, he smiles and says that he is all right. In his teacher's presence, he faces all his fate. Finally, the student feels happy with the teacher's presence being not just in his ninth grade teacher, but also his truest friend. So the meaning of the poem is, I think you have understood. What they are telling is, the teacher is not just a ninth grade teacher, but also his truest friend for the student. So I think you have understood it. I'll once again read the poem for you. I had nowhere to turn, had nowhere to go. This is just something I think you need to know. I don't know what made me trust you. I still remember the day when I told you what I have been through. I thought I should run away, go hide in a hole, but then you really brought out my true soul. As each day grew longer, our trust became stronger. Each time I wanted to cry, you stayed there right by my side. Then I moved to the next grade. Boy, was I afraid that our trust would slowly fade. But I was wrong. We are still strong. Even though sometimes you don't have time, you at least ask me if I am fine. Even though sometimes I'm not, I feel like I have just been shot. I smile and say, yes, I'm all right. Then I walk away and you're out of sight. I'll just have to wait and wait. I still have my feet. I'm so glad that you were there when I was sad. And this is what makes you not just my ninth grade teacher, my friend. So, I think you have understood the meaning of the poem. There are some meanings for you. First one is, trust means believe. Hide, put or keep something in a place where it can't be seen. Fade, something becoming paler or less bright. And your home assignment is, students, you find hard words from the poem. Whatever the word you feel difficult in writing the spelling or pronunciation, you just underline it and you write them in your notebooks along with the meaning. So your home assignment is, find hard words from the poem and write hard words and meanings in your notebooks. And we'll be continuing the remaining part of the lesson in the next session. Thank you. Have a good day.